Hey everybody, welcome to my next singing video here on YouTube. Well, I'm a little later in the day than I usually am doing these, but I got a good reason to be. This is a big song I did today. A lot of information to get across to you, so better get started right now. Well, we got a song here called Ticket to Ride, one of my favorite Beatles songs of all time. Came out in 1965, written by John Lennon and Paul McCartney, famous songwriting duo. This is actually my second Beatles song on my YouTube playlist, my karaoke songs. A while back I did Hey Jude for my first one. This is my 238th video on there overall. Ticket to Ride was primarily written by John Lennon and was credited to Lennon McCartney. In 1965, Lennon claimed that the song was three-quarters mine, quote, three-quarters mine, and Paul changed it a bit. He said, let's alter the tune. However, speaking in 1980, Lennon said that McCartney's contribution was limited to, quote, the way Ringo played the drums on the recording. In his 1997 authorized biography, McCartney contradicts this, providing an account more similar to Lennon's 1965 assessment. Quote, we sat down and wrote it together. Give him 60% of it. We sat down together and worked on that for a full three-hour songwriting session. Lennon said the closing section of the song, where there is a repeated repeated refrain similar to the last line of the chorus, quote, my baby don't care, was one of his favorite bits, quote unquote, in the song. He also claimed that Ticket to Ride was the first heavy metal record ever made. I found that it was in the power pop, jangle pop, and folk rock genres when I looked into it. The track's heavy sound may have been influenced by Lennon and George Harrison's first encounter with LSD. The song has also been called, quote, avant-garde masquerading as pop. While the lyrics describe a girl, quote, riding out of the life of the narrator, unquote, the inspiration of the title phrase is unclear, as is the meaning of the song. McCartney said the title referred to a, quote, British Railways ticket to the town of Ryde on the Isle of Wight, unquote. And Lennon said it described cards indicating a clean bill of health carried by Hamburg prostitutes in the 1960s. The Beatles played in Hamburg early in their musical career, and a quote-unquote ride was British slang for having sex. The song has also been interpreted as to be about a woman leaving her boyfriend to become a prostitute. Now, a little bit about the songwriters. Co-writer Lennon has written or co-written 284 songs that have been recorded by more than one artist, including Ticket to Ride, from Cry for a Shadow by Tony Sheridan, I think he was also known as the Fifth Beatle, on June 22, 1961, to Maria Helena Canta Beatles by Maria Helena in 2017. Co-writer McCartney has written or co-written 349 songs that have been recorded by more than one artist, including Ticket to Ride, from In Spite of All the Danger by the Quarrymen, which was a predecessor of the Beatles, on July the 12th, 1958, to The Kiss of Venus by Paul McCartney on December 18th, 2020. A little bit about the recording of Ticket to Ride. The Beatles recorded Ticket to Ride on February 15th, 1965, at EMI Studios in London. The session was produced by George Martin. The recording was a radical departure for the Beatles due to the vocals and lead guitar parts being overdubbed for the first time. The song's main guitar riff was played by Harrison, George Harrison, on his Rickenbacker 12-string guitar. He also played rhythm guitar on the song. Lennon sang the lead vocal, and played rhythm guitar, while McCartney sang harmony and played bass. The overdubs included electric guitar by Lennon and Harrison over the verses, and by McCartney, who also supplied the fills that closed the bridges in the solo over the coda. And Ringo Starr, he provided it's called whack and jump drum patterns, tambourine, and hand claps. The Beatles and their manager, Brian Epstein, selected Yes It Is to be the B-side of Ticket to Ride single, released in March 1965. That's when they selected the B-side. Not when the single was released. The record was issued by EMI's Parlophone label on April the 9th, 1965 in the UK, and by Capitol Records in the US on April the 19th, 1965. Ticket to Ride topped Britain's official singles chart for 3 weeks. It went straight in at number one on the national listings compiled by a Melody Maker, where it also stayed for 3 weeks, and similarly topped Ireland's singles chart in its first week of release over there. In America, the song entered the Billboard Hot 100 chart's top 40 on May 1st, 1965, and charted for 9 weeks, peaking at number one for 1 week on May 22nd. This was their 22nd top 40 hit in the U.S., their 8th number one hit, and their 3rd of 6 in a row, a record at the time, all within 12 months from January of 1965. Ticket to Ride also hit number one in Australia, Canada, the Netherlands, Norway, 2 charts in Sweden, and the U.S. Cashbox top 100 singles. It went to number 2 in South Africa and West Germany, number 3 in Finland, number 7 in Rhodesia, now known as Zimbabwe, I believe, number 8 in Austria, and number 10 in Belgium. So every place it charted, it was in the top 10. On the year-end charts for 1965, it ranked number 3 in South Africa, number 5 in the UK, number 31 on the US Billboard chart, number 36 on the US Cashbox chart. It was certified for sales of over 100,000 in France, 700,000 in the UK, and 750,000 in the US. Its 2010 UK release was certified silver with over 200,000 sales. The track appeared as track 7 on side 1 of their 5th UK studio album, Help, the soundtrack to their film of the same name, released in August 1965 on Parlophone. The album was released a week later in the US on Capitol, their 10th US album, on which Ticket to Ride was track 3 on side 2. A little bit about the cover versions now, one of my favorite sections. 279 cover versions of Ticket to Ride have been released to date. 162 of those are with the original lyrics in English. 101 are instrumentals with the same title and tune. 1 is an instrumental with a different title and the same tune. 2 of them are in English with different titles and lyrics but the same tune. 1 in Dutch, 3 in Finnish, 2 under one title and then 1 under another. 1 in French, 1 in German, 1 in Hebrew, 1 in Japanese, and 5 in Spanish, with 1 of those under one title and 4 of them under another. Some of the covers of the song with English lyrics are the following. By Mary Wells in October 1965 on her 20th Century Fox Records album, Love Songs to the Beatles. By Vanilla Fudge on August 23rd, 1967 on their self-titled Atco Records album. By The Fifth Dimension, arranged and conducted by Jim Webb in December 1967 on their Soul City album, The Magic Garden. By Carpenters on October 9th, 1969 on their A&M Records album, Offering. By Bee Gees in 1970 on their Carousel album, Inception/Nostalgia. By The New Seekers in March 1972 in a medley with Georgie Girl on their Polydor album, We'd Like to Teach the World to Sing. By Alan Caddy in 1972 on his Avenue Recordings album, A Tribute to the Carpenters. By the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra in 1983 in Beatles Medley on their Evolution Records album, The Royal Philharmonic Orchestra Plays the Beatles 20th Anniversary Concert. By Natalie Cole in 1991 on the SMV Enterprises video, The World's Greatest Artists Sing Lennon, A Tribute. And by Sonic Youth in March 2008 on their Goofin' Records CD, Master Equals Dick, in a medley with Master Equals Dick version, and Introducing the Stars. Now a little bit about the Beatles, because I could go on all day about them, but I can't. I don't have time. The Beatles were an English rock band formed in Liverpool in 1960, comprising John Lennon, born John Winston Lennon, named after Winston Churchill, on October the 9th, 1940 in Liverpool, England. He died on December 8th, 1980, aged 40, in New York City. He was murdered. Paul McCartney, born James Paul McCartney on June 18th, 1942, He's 81 today, soon to turn 82. He was born in Liverpool, England. George Harrison, born on February 25th, 1943 in Liverpool, England. He died on November the 29th, 2001, aged 58 in Los Angeles, California, of lung and brain cancer. And Ringo Starr, born Richard Starkey on July 7th, 1940. So he's now 83. And he was born in Liverpool, England also. They were all born in Liverpool. They performed in the rock, pop, beat, and psychedelia genres. They were active in the music business from 1960 to 1970. They recorded for the Apple label in addition to Parlophone and Capitol. A spin-off group of the Beatles was Plastic Ono Band, and the Beatles themselves were a spin-off of the Quarrymen. Here's something amazing. 3,470 records have been released on the Beatles under that and closely related names, plus 129 records with other artists and bands, for a grand total of 3,599 between 1962 and 2024, this year. Their discography includes 12 UK and 17 US studio albums, 5 live albums, 51 compilation albums, 22 video albums, 53 music videos, 36 EPs, 63 singles, 2 mashups, whatever those are, and 17 box sets. 20 of their singles reached number 1 in the US, the most all time. And they are the biggest selling band of all time with over 500 million records sold. So, I'm going to sing Ticket to Ride today.
I'll go get myself a little drink first because this song is hard to do.
I've done this song lots of times at karaoke at Dooley's over the years. Trouble is that I don't do it often enough and I always forget that song ends with that falsetto bit at the end there, so I've got to have some water. There we go. Hopefully that'll get me through this thing. It is going to be track number 14 on this CD here, which we're getting close to being finished with. One more song to go, and that'll be the end of it. Alrighty then, let's do Ticket to Ride. One of the greatest Beatles songs ever, I think. Here we go. Ed Sullivan introduced the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show by saying, "Ladies and gentlemen, the Beatles!" And then they went, "Ah!" That's the women and the girls screaming in the audience. Here we go now. Woo! I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. She says that living with me is bringing her down. She would never be free when I was around. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. She ought to think twice, she ought to be right by me before she gets to saying goodbye. She ought to think twice, she ought to do right by me. I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today, yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away, yeah. Oh, she's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. She ought to think twice, she ought to do right by me before she gets to saying goodbye. She ought to think twice, she ought to do right by me. says that living with me is bringing it down, yeah. For she would never be free when I was around. Ah, she's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. My baby 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 don't care. Woo! That's called Ticket to Ride by the Beatles, 1965, co-written by Lennon and McCartney. Hoo-ha! Well, I think I did better at that here today now than I have most of the times I've done it at Dooley's, actually. I usually crack up during that ending there. Well, I gotta say that's the end of this for another time. But, well, I'll be back soon enough. I'll be coming back again on the 30th of this month, which is Thursday, I believe. Let me see here. Thursday, yep. I'll be coming back on Thursday for another song, which is going to be a Canadian song. How about that? By who? The Guess Who. That's who. Called Shaking All Over, one of their early hits. So, and I got a little special connection to that song, because they're from Winnipeg, and so was my mom, and she had a little connection herself to the Guess Who, although she wasn't a big fan of them, but we'll get into that next time on the old video. And so for now, it's have a good day, and we'll see y'all again next time. Bye now.